performance. And leave it to be unraveled and experienced by the observer or listener. We are here to honor all of the artists and performers in the senior class who have spent countless hours practicing, all to share a special moment of their artistry with you all, one that concludes this moment in their life on stage or in the lobby art gallery. Tonight, you will leave lost for words with a warm heart. Welcome to Baccalaureate 2019. It is with great pleasure that I introduce Katie Burnell.
As a student in Bronxville High School, or truly any high school, it can often feel difficult to find that group of people who make you feel like you belong, your second family. I was lucky enough to find this within the arts. From performing in our school musicals, to singing in our chorus, to taking art classes, I met my best friends and, more importantly, mentors who my classmates and I will cherish for the rest of our lives. We can all turn to our orchestra director, Dr. Hooter, our band director, Mr. Iannelli, our playwriting teacher, Mr. D'Alessandro, our chorus and musical director, Ms. Simpson, our art teacher, Ms. Allen, and our English teacher and play director, Mr. Cross, as they've all provided us invaluable guidance throughout our high school careers. These teachers and mentors constantly work to create opportunities to explore and experience the arts. Through my arts mentors here at school, I've gotten to assistant direct plays, intern at art museums, see performances at the Metropolitan Opera, and I've even had the opportunity to sing at Carnegie Hall. Still, it can often be hard to feel seen as an artist in school. However, students are also taking an active role in ensuring that the arts thrive at Bronxville High School. Last year, I founded the Art Society, a club dedicated to promoting and celebrating the arts in Bronxville High School. I was inspired to take action to found this after seeing the inequality that existed within our school between athletics and the arts. I found that many of my classmates and friends, whose passions lived in the arts, as mine did, often felt unseen and unrecognized despite their immense talent and dedication. Since its founding, we've planned many events, from an in-school rock concert to our first ever Art Spirit Week, and launched a fundraiser which raised over $2,500 to support the One Love Foundation. Seeing my classmates participate so enthusiastically in the Art Society, despite their already busy schedules, has been immensely inspiring to me. Even more inspiring has been the students who have told me that they finally feel seen within our school environment. When I look back on my years in high school, I'll always cherish my memories within the arts. Late nights at tech rehearsals for the musicals, traveling to museums for my AP art history class, or even just simply chatting with my friends during chorus rehearsals. My fellow Bronxville students and teachers have made these memories all the more special, and I can't wait to see the class of 2019 make their mark on the arts in college and beyond. Thank you. I'd like to welcome my classmate and friend, Emmanuel Heber, to the stage.
Thank you.
Next, I would like to introduce Jack Parzyk performing Fool in the Rain by Led Zeppelin.
Michelle Coppola to the stage to perform Magic of Imagination.
And why don't you go and pass it around and someone just catch it for me when you feel ready. Oh. Anytime now. Woo! Oh. So today I brought with me a book we read in our freshman year English class. I really doubt anyone knows it. The Catcher in the Rye. Can I get a show of hands if you've read it or heard of it? Could you go and join me on stage? And go and give him a big round of applause as he makes his way up here. I even got you a mic right here. Perfect. Do you read a lot?
I do read a lot.
Okay. Awesome. So as I'm going through the book here, go ahead and say stop for me.
Stop.
Perfect. And what I want you to do is go ahead and look at the first word on the page as well as the page number. Got it?
I do.
Cool. We're going to do it again.
Okay. Stop.
Okay. Go look at the first word and the page number. Don't keep it to yourself. Got it?
I do.
Cool. Can you hold that book close to your heart?
Your chest, rather.
It's a book dear to you, right?
It is. Love this book.
Think of the letters. Think of the words. Continue thinking of the word. And what is the first letter in the word?
I'm allowed to tell you?
Yeah.
It's the letter T.
T, thank you. I knew that. And then there are four letters?
There are four letters.
Cool. And for a first time, could you tell them what the word you thought of was?
The word was took.
And what was the page number that you stopped on?
138.
138. How weird would it be if that page is now gone from the book entirely?
That would be very odd.
That would be very odd. In a normal setting, it would, but we are doing magic, so anything is possible.
I hear ya.
Can you go check that page for me? You said 138? Oh, but...
That's not it.
Oh, wait.
You're right, it was 118. It's gone.
It's gone. Go and show everyone. Yeah, really gone.
That's amazing.
But who has the balloon that we passed around earlier? Can you go and pass it up for me?
You needed to get somebody up here who doesn't wear reading glasses.
I actually have something for you.
Thank you.
See, because it has something
on
it.
It does say something. Yep.
So, all right. I think you know what happens next. Wait, do you hear something?
I never liked doing this.
Can you read the first word on that page after you unfold it?
It is took.
It doesn't fit into this page here?
That's the page.
Is that a fit? It is. Thank you very much.
That is amazing.
this would be for you if I didn't write it on the front cover. But you can have it anyway.
Oh, you're great. You have to autograph it.
Everyone give him a big round of applause and make his way back soon.
It's not simple to say that most days I don't recognize me, that these shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true was never attention sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy,
she bruised and kissed you.
Liam Greeley, Sid Malley, Jack Thermo, Antoine Trozzi, and Seamus Waters.
Waves by Dean Lewis.
is a swelling storm. And I'm caught up in the middle of it all. And it takes control of the person that I thought I was, the boy I used to know. But there is a light in the dark, and I feel its warmth in my hands, in my heart. Why can't I hold on? It comes and goes in waves, it always does, it always does. We watched as our young hearts fade into the flood, into the flood. And the freedom of falling, a feeling I thought was set in stone, it slips through my fingers, trying hard to let go. It comes and goes in waves, it comes and goes in waves, carries us away. Disappear in front of my eyes, moments of magic and wonder. It seems so hard to find. Is it ever coming back again? Is it ever coming back again? Take me back to the feeling when everything was left to find. It comes and goes in waves. It always does. Oh, it always does. And the freedom of falling, a feeling I thought was set in stone, it slips through my fingers, trying hard to let go. It comes and goes in waves.
Now performing Vengeance by Lionel Yu, I'd like to introduce my friend Isabella DeBeatty.
Thank you.
Next, I'd like to introduce Vance Wood performing Samson by Regina Spektor.
You are my sweetest downfall. I loved you first. I loved you first. Beneath the sheets of paper lies my truth. I have to go. I have to go. Your hair was long.
Performing Etude in A-flat major by Chopin.
Thank you.
how do you write an introduction for a writer, especially a really great one? That is the challenge I was handed when I learned that Mr. D was chosen to be our baccalaureate speaker. I thought, what would Mr. D do in this situation? I figured he would start by doing research. So I spoke to some seniors and asked them to describe this special guy whom we know as our Irish-Italian Frankie. For many of us, Mr. D was our first high school English teacher, and we were part of his very first classes here in Bronxville. Even though it has only been 4 years, he's become the heart and soul of our English department. A successful playwright himself, he single-handedly created the Bronxville Bards program, which is now a year-long class. In the process, has exposed students to the limitless world of theater. When I asked my classmates what they love about Mr. D, I found several common things. First, and most recurrent, was his sincere concern for each of his students. Personally, I have never met such a thoughtful man who seeks to form a strong bond with everyone he teaches. Mr. D makes each of us feel valued and gives us confidence in our abilities. Second, everyone agrees that it is his passion that sets him apart. He loves what he does, and that feeling is contagious. And third, Mr. D is a man with purpose. He often speaks to the playwright James Baldwin, who said, "The purpose of education is to create in a person the ability to look at the world for himself, to make his own decisions." Through the arts, Mr. D has taught us to express ourselves and to use our own voices. He inspires us to create change in the world every day. I am honored to introduce to you a teacher who has made a difference to so many of us, Franco D'Alessandro.
Good evening, faculty, friends, you amazing parents, and my dear, dear class of 2019. This is a special moment for me indeed, so I thank you for asking me to speak this evening. I joined the Bronxville faculty as you all entered high school, and we started this journey together, and I'm so deeply honored to be here now to close out this incredible experience with all of you. When I first came to Bronxville, I thought to myself what intellectually curious, uniquely talented, and genuinely kind young people. I still think that today, so please keep those brilliant qualities. Now that you're leaving us and commencing your adult journey, the question is, what will you seek? If you have one goal as the driving force in your life, let it be to seek meaning in all that you do, because a sense of purpose as to why you are here will enrich every aspect of your lives. If life has taught me anything, it's that the most unlikely friendships are the most rewarding. Just as the winding roads are the most interesting and the unplanned journeys the most inspiring. These are the ways to make life meaningful. Because life ultimately is about finding your tribe and connecting with a special people on the soul level. And I'll tell you, those people are not always the most likely candidates. There's actually an ancient Irish word, anamkara, which means your soul's friend. And those are the companions who enrich our lives with meaning and purpose. You see, in my high school years, I was lucky enough to have a very wise and very kind teacher named Mary Cronin. And she encouraged me to find my voice through writing. In sophomore year, she fortuitously gave me a journal, and she later told me it was to shut me up. I did a lot of talking in her class. I asked a lot of questions, and a lot like, well, we won't name any names. When I started writing, it was like a longed-for light had suddenly gone on in a room that had only known years of darkness. Despite a 16-year age difference, Mary and I forged a lifelong friendship that not only inspired me to become a teacher, but it began my career as a writer. Such are the priceless gifts that soul friends give to one another. Years later, I met another mentor friend, Pulitzer Prize-winning author, playwright Edward Albee. He was an instrumental mentor to me as a writer and a creative person. And while he was 40 years older than me, the difference did not stop us from becoming friends for 25 years. In his groundbreaking play, The Zoo Story, Albee wrote, "Sometimes a person has to go a great distance out of his way to come back a short distance correctly. I want you all to have that luxury, to get lost a little bit, to take the winding roads, to explore things with wide eyes and open hearts. Even when you think you're lost, you'll find purpose and meaning in your journey if you want to, if you try to, because you are indeed the authors of your own life stories. In the course of our 4 years together, we forged our own unlikely friendships. I've taught almost every one of you. We've had Celtic Club playwriting and independent studies. We've hung out after school and had early morning chats. We've ranted and raged about teenage injustices. I've helped a few of you through some pretty dark and tough times. I got you on stage as a writer or as an actor or both. You've spilled plenty of tea with me. We've gotten to analyze Game of Thrones and This Is Us. I've talked you off precarious personal ledges and out of college rabbit holes. I worried before and visited you after many, many surgeries. And I've even helped you get stains out of your parents' floors after a party. We've talked for hours about football, books, movies, theater, and politics. We've eaten a lot of pizza and pounds of cookies and candy. We had lunch together at Pete's and breakfast at Pondfield. And in the process of those magical moments of bonding and daring years of dreaming, I've watched you all grow into the finest, most exceptional group of young men and women I have ever had the pleasure of teaching. Tennessee Williams once said, "Affection is so vital. It is emotional oxygen. I believe that we die if we cannot love or be loved. Affection amplifies our humanity." I would add that affection is an expression of our gratitude for the people who give our lives meaning. Because my life changed that day back in June 2016, when many of you wrote me the sincerest, most beautiful thank you notes. And one of you even approached me and said, "Mr. D, a handshake just won't do. Bring it in for a hug." There you have it. A simple act of affection and gratitude creating purpose and meaning. And that is why my relationship with all of you means so very much to me, because you helped give deeper meaning and purpose to my own life. My teaching mantra has always been, be who you needed when you were young. I've tried to be that for you. I hope I've succeeded. Teaching you has been one of the great joys of my life. So I will leave you with these final, somewhat random, thoughts that a wonderful life filled with too much loss but a whole lot of love has taught me. Expect greatness from yourselves. Be relentless. Relentlessly be yourselves, even when you're not even sure who you are. Don't be taken in by the safety of populism and the simplicity of pessimism and the ease of apathy. Do things out of love and passion, not return on your dollar. Because the only wealth you have is not in the form of money, but rather in the formlessness of the human soul, whose currency is love, the truest and rarest kind of which is understanding. Integrity matters. Your habits inform your character and set the tone for your life. How you do anything is how you'll do everything. Mind the company you keep. My parents used to say, "Show me who your friends are, and I'll show you who you are." In the garden of your heart, cultivate gratitude. Time is far too precious to waste or kill. Good old Tennessee said, "The monosyllable of the clock is loss, 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 unless you devote your heart to its opposition." There's also a great Italian expression, "Don't cry over anything that can't cry over you." When faced with a choice, choose kindness and keep writing those thank you notes, because words matter. Expressing yourself is the definition of strength, and being stingy with emotions is the definition of weakness. Tell the people you love that you love them. Make it a goal for yourselves to be capable of being loved, and when you are, honor it. Look for life-changing acts of affection that will create meaning in your own lives. Continue to be extraordinary. Find the meaning and seek purpose in your own lives as you begin this awesome journey. Attempt great and strange things. Surprise yourselves. Go on unplanned journeys and adventures. Take the winding road. Forge unlikely friendships. Create enduring relationships and create meaningful roots. And of course, find your soul's friends. Because, my dear lassies and laddos, our lives are beautiful homes on fire, and we must always summon the courage to run in and rescue love. Thank you so much.
Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. He will hold me fast. I'll be home at last. Not a loser anymore, like the last time and the time before. Everybody loves a winner, so nobody loved me. Lady Peaceful, Lady Happy, that's what
Sandman. Snow-covered hills, maybe.
to introduce Samantha Kajosh singing Who I'd Be from Shrek.
I guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring upon a Viking ship. I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches. I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Well, I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I'd throw it. The stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and the nights would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke, with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn, but we all learn, and no girl always hides. An ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark. You're all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish was granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast. I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd save the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We'd stand and stare, we'd speak of love, we'd feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd have my destiny. I'd have a hero's ending. A perfect happy ending. That's how it would be. A big, bright, beautiful world. But not for me.
And Bailey Barden performing In My Life.
introduce Clea DeColius, Alex New, Andrea Shepherd, and Katie Quigley, who will be playing Don't Stop Believin' by Journey.
Thank you.
Say to Mommy by Giovanni Pergolesi.
Thank you.
Cassidy by Queen, I'd like to welcome my friends Tim Cushman and Paul McGough.
was our last performance of the night. Thank you all for coming to support our seniors, and a big congratulations to all of the performers. You guys were amazing. Thank you to John Klibanoff for his piano accompaniment. Mr. Iannelli, Mr. Ashley, and all the students who helped out with sound and lighting. And most importantly, thank you to Mrs. Wood and Mrs. Elder for organizing such a beautiful night. Thanks for coming.